Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome in. This is the Streamlabs OBS entry. Alright, let's go. Alright, so pretty much we'll go right down here in your options. This is where everything starts off. If you have issues with your Streamlabs or it's running stupid all of a sudden, you can go ahead and clear the coach and shit like that. That shit really helps. Man, that seemed a little loud on my end. There we go. The stream. This is where you kind of sign in and do your thing. Now you can do the multi-stream, but I do not think that it's a good idea. Because like, say, if I go into somebody's stream and I think they're multi-streaming to also Mixer and Twitch, I don't know if they're talking to me, if they're talking to someone else that I can't hear. I mean, and then if I do talk to them and they don't reply to me and they're replying to fucking Mixer first, yeah, fuck all that. Man. That's not how you make friends. That's not how you stream. That's trying to be greedy. All right, right here is the advanced output right here. So your AMD, your encoder here, now it can be X264 or it can be AMD. If you pick X264, it's gonna just take straight from your CPU for your Streamlabs OBS. Me personally, the only thing that's running off my GPU is my game. So if my video card can take a little bit of this encoding off of my CPU, which is your CPU is used by every fucking thing. You know what I mean? I recommend AMD or whichever graphics card you have. Alright, the preset is whatever. I mean, if I was you, I'd just do it yourself. Like we're going down through now, so I keep everything on balanced right here because, you know, I have good quality on my end and good performance, so I mean, might as well keep it in the middle if it ain't really a big deal. CBR, constant bitrate, is the default, especially for Twitch. That's all you want to use. I wouldn't even worry about it. Your target bitrate is going to be based on what resolution you're streaming and what your up speed is for your internet. So like my up speed's 35 megabytes up and I run 720 by 60 frames per second. So I think it's like 3500 to like 5000 is about right for 720p by 60 frames per second. I think it's like 5,000 to like 7,000 for 1080p, and then it scales down for everything else. I forget exactly what it is. But yeah, you won't, if you have like 5 megabytes upload speed, I'd keep it below like 3,500. Shit like that. Alright, audio. I don't ever mess with audio. I just leave it all like this. Alright, so this is going to be your base canvas. This is what you see on your monitor, which mine's technically 1922 by 1080, but 1920 by 1080 is just the same. The rescaled output resolution. This is what you're going to be streaming down towards Twitch. So like I told you earlier, I'm doing 720p by 60 frames per second. So. Alright, you have this LAN, which is technically the best. It takes the most usage. So I don't remember if it's CPU or GPU, but it uses more. Bilinear is the one that takes the least amount. It kind of gives you a blur instead of like a stop whenever shit's kind of getting out of focus. And this is where you pick if you want 30 frames per second or 60 frames per second. If you want to save a little bit, like if your usage is getting a little high and you really don't want to switch or anything else, this is what I would switch. Switch it down to 30 frames per second instead of 60. You can not really tell the difference between 30 and 60 unless you see 60 after 30. You know what I mean? As like outside of that, you really can't tell. I mean, it still looks pretty fucking good with 60 frames per second, but it still is really good with 30 frames per second. Just keep that in mind. Hotkeys. The only thing I have hotkeyed is an emergency mute and unmute, which I have on my keyboard for easily access. So say like if I hear something or if I want to take my headset off real quick or something like that, I just bam, unmute, mute, etc. Everything else I really don't mess with here. It really doesn't make too much of a difference. Alright, so you got signing in, you have your basic options there. And now you gotta like making a layout. So we'll keep it on this here. We'll start with alert box because this is what pops up whenever somebody like subs to you, etc., etc. I'll just keep everything on source. So this is where you would actually customize your actual each individual by loading in like a GIF file or whatever. Where does it make it? Like each one of mine, like I don't have one for merch because I don't sell merch through here. Subscriber. And each one can play a different song, different name. You can change the template. Yeah, I mean, this is where you actually want to go in and really do it in. You can put some individually for each one. I want to change that picture for the raid. I wish I had a picture for it ready. We would rock it out right now. But yeah, you can test widgets after you're done.
Hot Jeff.
It's jackpot.
All I know now is that we're a filthy bit.
I'm Rand Fish. And this.
Right?
Is to go.
So now you got your alert box on. So now when people follow you, sub to you, cheer to you, etc., now you know. Alright, so now we're going to load in an image. Alright, so we're going to start with a bottom bar. Let's call it bar. See, now I keep all of my stuff in the same files here. So we got stream stuff, you got our GIFs, you got our overlays, you got our sounds. I mean, so we'll go into here. Go purple. Purple bar. And the thing I like about bars is if you don't make them the exactly same height you need, you know, just make it bigger. It'll always be a little bit different depending on what game you're playing. Alright, so we'll go here and I'll show you two different ways for, like, say your new follower thing. So I have some that are already pre-made through Photoshop. Oh fuck. Dropped it. Got too small when I got it short. Drink. This bar is actually a lot smaller than what I would normally rock with. I don't want to cover up too much. Normally I'd bring up like a screenshot of the game that I'm actually playing. You can use the number keys, like number pads, that kind of like move it around a little bit instead of like jerking it around with the fucking mouse. Or the other way you can do it is just straight up go in and make your own text right here. Make a brand new one. Follow. You can go in here. New follower. You can go up here, you change. We'll start here first. Pretty much change whatever font you want. Go to bold. We'll keep it red. Nope. Use the number keys, like I said, you can kind of zone it in a little easier. There we go. New follower. Alright, next is, we'll go in here. Stream labels. Start brand new. Alright, so we want a new follower. Recent donator. Watch out, probably freaking passed it. I feel like I always pass it at least once going down. Alright, here we go. Total follower count. Most recent follower. You can see there's a bunch of different ones, man. So you can always just sit there and rock out. Alright, so. And like I said, you can do the same thing. Properties. Come in here. Change that. Go with some green. I don't even know what that fucking looks like. Looks like shit. Yeah, bold here. We do got a bold. That's all you see here. Yeah, it doesn't look that bad, I guess. For just fucking winging it here. Yeah, you can kind of position it however you want. Yeah, this is with the. So now we got like the pre version I had in already made, and then now we have the one we just made right now. And then you have the stream labels. Let me see here. Use media source if you want to add like a GIF or like something cool. Always hit loop, because if it's a GIF, it'll stop moving. New stuff. GIFs. So we're just gonna have a little Pikachu sitting here waving at you guys as we're chilling. I think that's just about all the main. Alright, so right here we have the game capture and display capture. Game capture is if you already have the game up and you specifically want to match it. You just hit that, load it in. See, like I already have a bunch on here. And capture any full screen application. That would pop up if you have it on full or capture specific. So, like, this is where it would pop up in the second little window here. It's like if you capture any full screen application, anything that's full screen, like Dragon Ball FighterZ, you don't run at full screen. You just don't. But you can say with like Tekken 7 or something like that. So you want to capture a specific window, and after the game's already up, then it'll be right here in this list. Cool. And you can do more, you know, messing around with that. Move that, and then show you the display capture. Brand new display capture. And then this is basically just a little drop down. Shows all three of your, in my opinion, in my case, monitors. So, cool. That's how you get a display capture. Alright. So like, that's what I did down here. Like, these are just display captures with different renames. Alright, so now we'll go down through the list here. Image, browser source. This is how I load my controller onto the screen so people can see what buttons I'm pressing, because it's just a site that generates a URL. You just pop it into browser source. Image slideshow. I guess it's for people that want to show things in consecutive order over and over and over. Display capture, game capture, we just went over that. Audio input capture. You really only need if, you know, you want to add something else into it. Scene, if you want to overlap a scene with a scene. Color source, kind of shows itself. Media source, we just went over how you want to show GIFs. This is the text, the window capture. It's basically the same thing as display in game, but if you want to display like a window within a window, that's where you get it. Same thing. Alert box, this is default, super default. I really don't use a follower goal. Yeah, most of the stuff I don't use. Stream labels, of course, it's needed. I would recommend not doing the viewer count. Just saying. Unless you're like way up there, but then you wouldn't be looking at this fucking video. So I think that is it. That's pretty much the over of Streamlabs OBS. And hope you guys have a good time. If you guys need any more or have any more questions, again, drop them in the comments. Until next time, guys. This is Conway. I'm out. Everybody got a different version of me.